This is the kind of pivot table we are used to seeing. The row IDs come from the group column, the column headers from the pivot column, and the cell values result from the aggregation method applied to the aggregation column. However, more complex pivot tables are also possible. For example, we might need a pivot table with two or more group and pivot columns. We will show some examples here on how to achieve more complex pivot tables using the pivoting node. The dataset we use in this video contains customer data. In this demo, we focus on the following columns. Web activity, including 6 different web activity categories from 0 to 5. Sentiment analysis, including 5 different attitude categories. Marital status, including 2 categories, married and single. Gender, with 2 values, male and female. And the products column, including 5 different investment products. Let's start with the first example, where we create a pivot table like this with 2 pivot columns. This pivot table shows the most popular product, the mode of products, in each customer group defined by sentiment, gender, and marital status. In this pivot table, the sentiment values produce the row IDs. The possible combinations of gender and marital status, that is, married female, single female, married male, and single male, produce the column headers. The cells contain the mode of the investment products in these data groups. Let's take a look at the settings required for this pivot table. First, we open the configuration dialog of the pivoting node. In the Groups tab, we include the sentiment analysis column in the set of group columns. Then, in the Pivots tab, we add 2 columns, marital status and gender, to the set of pivot columns. In the Manual Aggregation tab, we select the Products column and apply the aggregation method mode to it. Let's move on to the next example, where we create a pivot table with 2 group columns like this. We consider the same customer groups as in the previous example, that is, groups defined by sentiment, marital status and gender. This time, however, the gender and marital status columns define the row IDs, while the sentiment values define the column headers. The aggregation method we use here is a concatenation of the unique web activity categories represented in each group. Let's take a look at the settings in the configuration dialog of the pivoting node. In the Groups tab, we include the marital status and gender columns in the set of group columns. Next, in the Pivots tab, we include the sentiment analysis column in the set of pivot columns. In the Manual Aggregation tab, we select the Web Activity column and apply the aggregation method Unique Concatenate. Unique Concatenate isolates the unique values in the aggregation column for each data group and then concatenates them together into a string using a selected value delimiter as the separator. We can change the value delimiter to hyphen or semicolon, for example, in the lower part of the configuration dialog. The menu for available aggregation methods also contains the aggregation method concatenate, which concatenates all values in the aggregation column for that group without removing the duplicates. This option, unique concatenate with count, concatenates the same values together into a string, including the number of their occurrences. In this video, we have presented some advanced layouts of the pivot table and shown how to set the pivoting node to achieve them. We have shown how to group and/or pivot by one or more columns and introduced new aggregation methods, mode, and different forms of concatenate. The pivoting node, similar to the group by node, is a very versatile node. It allows you to apply a number of different aggregation methods for each data type and shape the final results in a pivot table with as many separate data groups as needed.